fixing to bring out here. This is more our era of time.
Hi, this is Brad Buckner from sharpensbest.com. How you doing today? Down here in Florida, out with Aaron Phillips from Naked and Afraid Discovery Channel. And we talked a little bit about me coming down here and spending some time with him. And Aaron and I met at the Blade Show, Atlanta, this year, Blade Show 16. Come off on another little adventure. Let's look around here. This place called King's Landing on the river. And river trips, canoes, things like that. So we'll do a little looking around. We'll point back out here where I know I can see some kind of residence over there, probably the owners. Cool place out here. And there's the owner. It's upside down, but there it is. You can figure it out. And Aaron's the one with the hat on. That's Aaron Phillips. We kind of hit it off at Blade Show. This is Brad, sharpensbest.com. Take care, have a good day. Aaron was just saying that Rock Springs, the springs itself that creates the waters here, is about 2 miles up that way. Oh, well. Uh-huh. I probably should have put my flip-flops on. Aaron just said that I got a lead ass. He had to get out and push. I offered to help and he said, no, you got too much of a lead ass. I'll do it all.
If I didn't love doing it, I'd be complaining. I can't complain right now.
I love being out here. Yep. If a guy could literally make a living just being up and down the river and stuff. Because my schedule for shows is insane. I do 48 to 50 shows a year.
That just blows my mind. That is awesome.
It's hard to catch that many planes, cars, drive.
It's inspiring to me.
Yeah. Yeah, it is, actually. I built my pontoon boat on this river would be fantastic.
That almost looks like a log rig. Where they'll dive the rivers and find these logs that have been submerged.
Uh-huh.
You know, 100, 200 years. You'll see these pontoons with them. Not a setup like that, but they'll have like a cherry. Now, turn of the century, 1900s, you had squatters that lived out here on the river, and they were true river people.
Yeah.
They lived off the river. There's no roads to get to their homes.
Oh, slow down.
Great catcher. Okay. Right at 11 o'clock. And I'd say that's roughly 3.5, 4 foot.
And that was one of your study subjects?
What's that?
That little gator.
Yeah, that's for a guy named Forrest Galante.
Yeah. I'd never seen anything like that before. Man, that's clear.
Off to the right or left, you'll see small creeks running into this run here.
Uh-huh.
There's springs out there, unnamed springs. They're really small. We call them boils, like what you're describing.
Right.
Like a sand boil. Maybe 10 to 50 gallons a minute, if that.
Right. And the Society for Gators, whoever in the hell this is, thinks they don't exist. So they make all of their assumptions based on paper and reading what should be conducive to a alligator's life.
Yep.
And then they create a study in their mind.
Pretty much.
Yeah, and then put it out to the world
as
scientific fact. No real research that's actually real. Put out what you want people to know, and the people who aren't out and about don't know the difference. And the smallest one's probably what, 3.5 feet?
Yep. It's definitely not a
moose. Yeah.
It's a juvenile, a little too close. They do some really strange stuff.
Really?
They'll arch their back out of the water and vibrate and like ripple the water off of themselves.
Yeah?
It's pretty intimidating, I tell you what.
Especially if it's what, an 8-10 footer?
Yeah. And that's a good size gator.
Well, you know, just the size would intimidate you if it did nothing, because you understand what it can do if it chose to.
Exactly, the potential's there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That was the only time I've ever had a gator actually pursue me in a canoe.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie. There's been times where I've gotten in the water and I know there's gators in the area. I can see it, you know, laying up on the bank on the side, and I've had them slip in and kind of move in my direction.
Right.
And then I slip out.
You slip out.
I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's just smart.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like you say, if I respect what can eat me in a heartbeat. Isn't it funny how this tree isn't going to give up? It just grows straight up out of the... What'd you call it, an orb?
It's a golden orb.
Okay, we got a golden orb spider here and his web. Also be called a banana spider. Turn and kind of duck right into the...
Yeah.
Okay, we got a bunch of gar here. 18, 20 inches. Got a whole school of them. I hope you can see them. That's what I'm pointing at. Oh, yeah. Oh, you GoPro on it?
Yeah, underwater.
Underwater, cool.
Money shot, you get it?
Yep.
Oh, you're my hero, Brad. Holy cow.
I'm pretty sure.
That's good stuff, man.
Alright. I'm pretty sure. I think that's gonna be a keeper. Oh, little turtle. So can you literally canoe from here to the salt water?
Oh yeah, I've done it. Yep. You'll go north. All right, well, we're trying not to rock the boat too much. good size, basically, for cloning, for root production, and for multiplying.
Really?
Before Seminole, there was the Calusa, the Timaquan. There was about 10 or 12 throughout the state of Florida. Prior to that, we don't know anything about the indigenous people that were here prior to that, but we know they were here up to 15 to 20,000 years.
That's all natural nature. Leave it alone. Don't walk on it.
Exactly. There's the unspoken rule that if you find yourself in a position when the sun's setting and maybe it's a environmental issue or just poor planning or whatever it is, and you've got to make camp, then, well, you know, you've got to make camp.
Right.
You know, rather be tried by 12 than carried by 6.
Yeah.
So, you know, that rule does apply, but, you know, on the right-hand side here, that's where they prefer that. People on half-drunk shit, jumping out the tree.
Yeah.
Flying off. Not such a bad day.
You know? No, not such a bad day, yeah.
Can't complain too much.
Yeah. Well, it does get deeper over there, doesn't it?
What, right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit.
Gonna get your shirt wet. Where are we, Aaron?
We are at Otter Camp on the Rock Springs Run. We're about 4.5 miles from where we started. We got about 3.75, about 4 miles to go.
Yeah.
Before we come out at Wakaiva Island.
Wakaiva Island.
Mm-hmm. And that's just past where the Rock Springs Run that we're on now joins the Wakaiva River. Wakaiva Springs is right there, the headwaters. The two come together. And then from there, it's probably a good 10 or 12 miles, something like that, until you get to the St. John's River.
Yeah?
Yep.
Well, it's been a really good time. It's a beautiful day. It's a little warm. It's not bad. I don't think this is really too bad at all. Sweating a little bit, but not too bad. We've got a river there we're going to go play in a little bit. This is Brad, sharpensbest.com. Aaron Phillips. You might know him from Naked and Afraid. Maybe his website, things like that. He lives down here in Florida. And I came down for a gun show. I actually came down to see Aaron and worked at the gun show to kind of pay for the trip. So, just down here having some fun, out, doing a little photography, floating down the river in a canoe. We're looking for some gators and, you know, whatever we can find, and just the wildlife, things like that. Well, right now we've got a sub sandwich, so it's lunchtime. I'm Brad Buckner, and this is
Aaron Phillips from Life Survival.
Life Survival, look them up. Lifesurvival.com?
Lifesurvival.net.
.net, okay. Yep. Lifesurvival.net, look them up. Follow them, help, donate, whatever, I don't know,
times.
Volunteer, get involved, help people get back to nature.
That's
and,
the goal.
You know, help keep things clean and stuff like that.
That's the goal. Connecting people with nature. It's our way of saving the planet. It's tough to have respect for something you don't have a relationship with. That's where life survival comes in.
Yep.
You got the forest play dates for the little kids and everything all the way up, family adventures, and we'll even go out and do some one-on-one type stuff with nothing but a knife. We'll spend 5 days in the swamp. Good times. Eating mussels and crawdads and dodging gators.
Well, you know what? If we're going to go out with nothing but a knife, I probably need a different one.
You might want to bring something a little bigger than that. Right?
Maybe off my table. Bring something off. EJ's knife.
Yeah. Bring the SXB.
The SXB. EJ Snyder's knife that he designed to take on one of his challenge. By the way, I sold the first one that I've sold off of my table yesterday. And Aaron got to be there for the birth of a new era. And so we'll share that with EJ. That'd be EJ Snyder, Discovery Channel, Naked and Afraid. I think he was on Lost, 40-day challenge. And now is the co-host of Dual Survival with Jeff. What's Jeff's last name?
Jeff Zelch.
Zelch?
Zouch.
Oh, Zouch?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Jeff Zouch. So look them up. And so you take care and have a good time. Any last words?
Get outside.
Get outside. Find nature. This is Brad. And Aaron?
Aaron Phillips from Life Survival.
Take care. We'll see you later.
See you guys.
Yeah.
30% cloud cover.
Right.
Good. 30% cloud cover. It's not too hot. I mean, it's in the low 90s right now. I said, this is a good day on the run.
Yeah. Where are you guys from?
I'm from Orlando. He's from Philadelphia.
Oh, that's a long boat. A long boat trip, Philadelphia.
Yeah, it is.
He's delayed.
Okay. Well, good luck with everything. We got some swimmers. We got some beautiful moss. Beautiful scenery.
It's never been logged, as far as I know, which is a big thing.
Yeah.
Hey, make sure you get pictures of these chicks up here. I'm digging it.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
See any gators?
Four?
We just heard one.
Yeah, gator. Yeah.
Right
off over there. Yeah. Well, let's go find him.
Hey, look for him on the
Aaron Phillips.
Yep.
Now you're going to be on my YouTube channel. It's called Sharpensbest.com. I'm not kidding. You will be. It's national. It's big. That the river would wash a log down, or the river would change. It'd wash in a sandbar, and that whoever jumps off is going to end up a major pygmy. You know, with knees in chest type of a thing. This is pretty cool. I like this. Huh? Yeah. Mush, husky, mush. That's probably about deep enough, huh?
Just right.
That's right. Just people having fun.
Life survival. It's an everyday thing.
Yeah. How you doing?
Chilling, man.
That's right.
Catch your eyes.
Yeah. Back to King's Landing, went down the river, had some good time, got some sun, went and got some swimming time in. It was a lot of fun. And that was with Aaron Phillips from Naked and Afraid, Discovery Channel. That was a lot of fun. He lives down here in Florida. So anyway, just off on another little adventure, brought you along with me, and pretty soon we'll have the footage on our YouTube channel. That'd be Sharpens Best. Go to Sharpens Best, and that would be / YouTube / Sharpens Best. A lot of fun, good time. You know, seen a lot of stuff on the river, seen four alligators. They were somewhere in the neighborhood of 3 feet to about probably 6 feet. And there are some people who say that those alligators don't exist here. We proved them wrong. They're on video right now. We've seen some turtles, some egrets, some birds, flies in your eyes. And just had a really good time. King's Landing. Fun place. Good time, warm weather, beautiful day, not too hot. That's where we took off from. right out that way. The river's about 150, 200 feet, something like that. Had a lot of fun. Wonderful day. Stopped and had some lunch. This is Brad, sharpensbest.com. You take care and have a good day. We'll see you up the road. Bye. Free beer. I love free beer. We can have from... Holy sh... Yeah. Yeah, free beer in my butt. It's Brad. See you later.